must remember this. A kiss is still a kiss. A sigh is just a sigh. The fundamental things apply as time goes by. And when two lovers woo, they still say, I love you. On that you can rely. No matter what the future brings, as time goes by. Moonlight and love songs, never out of date. Hearts full of passion, jealousy and hate. Woman needs man, and man must have his mate. That no one can deny. It's still the same old story, a fight for love and glory, a case of do or die. The world will always welcome lovers as time goes by. Welcome, lovers, as time goes by.
Yeah, you will. don't you take any pictures of me crying.
Not because of your
I'm
state
trying to
the whole day.
If you'll hold your head still, I can match up this Velcro, okay?
Can you turn that a little bit more closely?
Okay, here we go. Ready? On the count of three. One, two. Nice smile. One more time. Here we go. Good. One more. Very nice. Okay, are you stepping in? What's your name?
There you go. Grant, look over here, Grant. There you go, champ. One more time. Here we go. Ready? Good.
I'll get the portable.
Thank you.
Fine, you should have town, sorry.
You wouldn't be calling if you didn't.
I forgot my medals. What are they? I'm calling it off.
Oh, speed up.
You wouldn't do that.
You already stopped by today.
Up here, I peeked out through the window.
Behind him. Just like drove by.
I had to get the Spanish reading. I had to print it out.
I would do this. Hold it down here and tilt it forward.
What am I about to
do? This way.
Oh, no.
Oh, videotape.
Just stop it.
Smells beautiful.
I'm gonna throw that in heavy.
No, I'm not. Yeah.
How is she not coming to the wedding?
She was, the boys were saying something about she was sick.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Larry, we can just have somebody read it in English. That's probably why you couldn't.
It's, put it on, but they're orange.
What's in the bag?
Large
enough to put on the bumpers, maybe?
Or exactly. Just turn those wires.
He's going to get
so that
he's all set. He doesn't have to do a thing.
Oh, it doesn't matter, but
church.
Just so you bend them. Bend them up so they don't
bend. One less person for you to worry about.
Thank you.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
No, you dropped in the water. Oh,
Hey Jack, wait for me with my pocketbook, please. You be in charge, okay? Okay. Somebody walk in. Whatever you just want to
all of you to this this wedding, the wedding of Jorge and Laura, who have come into this house, this church, to celebrate God's love for them and their love for each other, and to ask us to love them in their new life as husband and wife. We are delighted to be here to watch the solemnization of these vows before the altar of God. And so we begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace, the peace of God our Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ be always with you. Let us pray. Father, hear our prayers for Jorge and Laura, who today are united in marriage before your altar. Give them your blessing and strengthen their love for each other. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Please be seated for the reading of the Word.
Love is always patient and kind. It is never jealous. to hope, and to endure whatever comes. Love does not come to an end. The word of the Lord.
Steep climbs and occasional collisions.
because they know that love can bear all things, hope all things, endure all things. But you know, love is a task. Love is not easy. The task which is set out is in the reading from Corinthians. Love is patient and kind. Well, sometimes we don't want to be patient and we don't want to be kind. Love is not envious or self-seeking. A wise priest used to say to a couple who came to him to be married, you know, this marriage won't work. And the point that the priest was making is that every marriage has to be made to work. It doesn't happen automatically. In fact, Jorge and Laura will only see the strength of their love for each other when they see what it costs in effort, in generosity, in forgiveness, and understanding. Love grows only in overcoming selfishness. And so they do not sit on the road alone, especially this road. That is the meaning of our presence here with them today. People who love them, who will be with them, they are setting out to begin as a sign of joy and hope, of the life-giving power of love which God has given to us. That is why marriage is a sacrament. And if you recall in the bygone days, in the good old days, a sacrament is a sign, an outward sign. And what does a sign do? It shows us something. Well, Jorge and Laura are showing us what God's love is all about. They can show that in their own home, in the way they enrich each other and the children that the Lord may send them. They can show that in their relationship with us, their relationship with their family, their friends. And in that way, they enrich the whole community to which they belong. And so we pray for them today that they may have a marriage that fills their home and all around them with a love that never fails, and that they may always share and know the fulfillment of Christ's promise, that this joy can be in them and that their joy may be fulfilled in Christ. I have a request for you today, as I request all my couples. I ask you not to follow the secular society of today. Don't follow Melrose Place, 9012, Beverly Hills, Young and the Restless. What's some of the others? You've been watching them, haven't you, Mom? What I ask of you is to remain faithful and committed, because the world today needs to see commitment. It needs to see fidelity. The last 35 years of this world has been a disaster because we have lost the sense of faithfulness. We have lost the sense of commitment. I pray today, as you pray before this altar, that your love will be that commitment to each other, and it will be renewed every day of your lives when you get up. That you know that the Lord loves you, and that your love will grow in each other because of Him. Amen. Myself and this whole church community. Christ abundantly blesses your love. He has already consecrated you both in baptism, and now enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament that you may assume the duties of marriage and mutual and lasting faithfulness. And so in the presence of this church, I ask you to state your intentions. Jorge and Laura, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage? Will you love and honor each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives? Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law, Christ, and His church? Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, join your right hands. And declare your consent before God and His church.
I, for the Lord, thank you, Laura Pita, my wife. I promise to be with you in the time of death. Thank you for the Lord. I will love you and honor you for the day of my life.
Yo, Laura Pita, te tomo a ti por el mes para ser mi esposo. Prometo serte fiel en tiempos buenos y malos, en enfermedad y en salud. Te amaré y te honraré todos los días de mi vida.
You have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in His goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with His blessings. When God is joined, man must not divide. Lord, bless and consecrate Jorge and Laura in their love for each other. May these rings be a symbol of true faith in each other and remind them always of their love. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Jorge,
take this ring
as a sign of my love and fidelity
in
the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Urging you to reach out in loving service to the poor these members of the Jorge and Laura Pita and Laura families in gratitude for the gift of their lives and in the hope that they are enjoying the fullness of life with God. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Father, you have chosen us and given us your love, the power of the Holy Spirit within our midst. Hear our prayers today and keep us open. May our faith issue forth always in action, our love show itself in deeds, and our hope give us courage. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Please be seated for the preparation of gifts.
Christian marriage, you bring together two orders of creation, nature's holy in thee, the fountain of all holiness. Let your spirit come upon me to make us holy, that we may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Before he was given up to death, the death he freely accepted, he took bread. He gave you thanks and praise. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, he took the cup. Again he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the cup to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Remember all our brothers and sisters have gone to their rest in the hope of rising again. Bring them and all the faithful departed into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us all. Make us worthy to share eternal life with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God and our Mother, Joseph, her husband, with the apostles, especially John, the martyrs, and all the saints who have done your will throughout the ages. May we praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through and with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Let us stand now and pray with confidence to the Father in the words Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Let us pray to the Lord for Jorge and Laura, who come to God's altar at the beginning of their married life, that they may always be united in love for each other as they now share in the body and blood of Christ. Holy Father, you created humankind in your own image and made man and woman to be joined as husband and wife in union of body and heart. So fulfill their mission in this world. Father, to reveal the plan of your love, you made the union of husband and wife an image of the covenant between you and your people. In the fulfillment of the sacrament, the marriage of a Christian man and woman is a sign of the marriage between Christ and the Church. Father, stretch out your hand and bless Jorge and Laura. Lord, grant that as they begin to live this sacrament, they may share with each other the gifts of your love and become one in heart and mind as witnesses to your presence in their marriage. Help them to create a home together and give them children to be formed by the gospel and to have a place in your family. Give your blessings to Laura, your daughter, so that she may be a good wife and mother, caring for the home, faithful in love for her husband, Jorge, generous and kind. Give your blessings to Jorge, your son, so that he may be a faithful father, a faithful husband, and a good father. Father, grant that as they come together at your table on earth, so may they one day have the joy of sharing your feast in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and the unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let us offer each other a sign of that peace. This is Jesus, Son of the living God. The Lamb of God who has taken away the sin of the world. Happy we who are called to this meal. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed.
Thank you.
Almighty God, may the sacrifice we have offered and the Eucharist we have shared strengthen the love of Jorge and Laura and give us all your fatherly aid. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessings. May God, the Almighty Father, give you his joy and bless you and your children. May the only Son of God have mercy on you and help you in good times and in bad. May the Holy Spirit of God always fill your hearts with his love. And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. This Mass is ended. Let us go in love and peace to serve God and each other.
Everybody has to be. Thank you. they'll be unhappy if they don't put it on.
Mr. and Mrs. Jorge.
To get like cheek to cheek, you just lean in.
Like this?
Just like that, beautiful, just like that.
Beautiful, very nice. Good.
Okay. What's it coming up? Now we have portraits, black and white. You want to do those right here?
Sure.
Yeah. Those right here?
Yeah. Thank you.
Yours closed. Good. Can I see this bouquet for a second? I want you to do it with your right hand. I want you to like take his face like this and bring it in and give him a kiss. Yeah, it's like that. Good. Beautiful. Good.
Are making us laugh.
There you go.
Good. Where's Bobby?
One more. Good. Beautiful. Hold on. Very nice. Good. Okay.
Beautiful.
Yes, very good. Yeah.
Mom and Bobby Mark. Do you want her necklace on the outside?
Very nice. Okay, here we go.
Do you want your necklace on the outside?
Beautiful. Congratulate the room here. Say, congratulations, how's it going? Good job, good luck, anything.
Congratulations. I no longer want to murder you.
Good. Beautiful.
Oh, it's okay, champagne.
Alright.
me. Oh,
take everything you say off, Bob.
Good, just like that. Beautiful. Okay, here we go. Very nice. Nice and tall. Can you look closer? Good, right there.
Don't touch each other. Yeah, you know, like you melt no. together if you touch each other.
Good. Beautiful. Good.
Thank you.
All right, reception bound or what?
Yeah.
Representing Sandalio Pita. Bridesmaid and usher, Christine Farino, accompanied by Emilio Rivello. Farino, accompanied by Fernando Arango. Monica Valera, accompanied by Adrian Arango. Valera, accompanied by Robert Burt. Jessica Pita, accompanied by Michael Burt. Accompanied by Larry Arango. Kathy Nino, accompanied by John Burt. And the two beautiful little kids. The flower girl and ring bearer, Emily Burt and Grant Lincoln. Let's give them a great welcome. Maid of honor and best man, Elizabeth Burt and Alex Rio. Ladies and gentlemen, the moment we've been waiting for tonight, for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Jorge Luis Pita. Let's give him a great welcome. The honor of the first dance. The wedding party may go straight to the head table, please.
Falta a esta noche blanca, a nuestras vidas que ya han vivido tanto, que han visto mil colores de sábana, de seda. Y cuando llueve, te gusta caminar, vas abrazándome.
Así la noche dura un poco. This is a big win. Very welcome here. Now the bride would have the honor to have first dance with her father.
Cuando salí de Cuba,
enterrado mi corazón. Cuando salí de Cuba, dejé mi vida, dejé mi amor. Cuando salí de Cuba, dejé enterrado mi corazón. Azotando sin descansar, pero el sol de tus hijos pronto la calma te hará alcanzar. Cuando salí de Cuba, dejé mi vida, dejé mi amor.
Let's give a big hand, mother and son.
Mi corazón no lo tengo aquí.
As we prepare to share this meal with Laurie and Jorge, to remember that God is present with us, to thank God for the blessing that we have to be present with them as they share their first meal together as husband and wife. We continue to ask God's blessing on them, on the love they share, on all those who are part of their family and friends. We ask God to bless the meal we share, to help us to nourish each other by the love and care that we share with one another. And we ask this blessing through Christ our Lord.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to propose a toast to Mr. and Mrs. Jorge and Laura Pita. First of all, for those of you that don't know, Jorge is more than my first cousin, he's my mentor, so... First of all, for those of you that aren't aware, Jorge is not only my first cousin, he's my mentor. We go back quite a ways. And I'm very honored to be amongst all of the wonderful gentlemen and ladies in this room and to be the best man amongst all these people. I also like to just let you know, I was prepared to come up here and without knowing Laura, of course, to simply say that based on how well I know Jorge, I know that she had to be the jewel of his life, the star in his sky. And now I'm really happy to be able to go home and know without a doubt, with absolute certainty, that she is just that person. And we definitely do deserve each other. I wish you both a very long, prosperous life full of happiness. And I wish you sincerely, genuinely, a fruitful life full of plentitude and fulfillment. To Jorge and Laura Pita.
Salud.
Salud.
We got enough single ladies here tonight. Here we go. easy now, when I tell you, okay? Here we go.
Very hot. Pita, very hot.
Real sexy. Now we need all the single guys. All the single guys. We need a young lady on the chair. There we go now. Are you ready for this one?
Thank you.
Thank you. Kiss each other. Okay, hold it.